Good morning. We are group one, and with our first case study, my name is Nikki, and I'm going to introduce you to our first case study. And basically, we are going to look at the yogurt market, and it's an old existing market, and we need to revolutionize how we have a marketplace. And currently, the grocery stores are full of choices, and most consumers are overwhelmed. They do not know the difference between them, and but they know that yogurt is healthy, and they want to have a quick, healthy lifestyle addition. And so for this, we want to see how IP can change the market, how our customers benefit, the pros and cons of a fortress monopoly, and the value-added monopoly, and the role of IP as an instrument for resource protection and also as a instrument for design of market position. And the rest of my group members are going to explain each one of these individually.
And then here we are with this, our business model for the probiotic yogurt will provide us with a competitive advantage through the differentiation process. In fact, we will provide the customer with, we would like to go from food to functional food, providing tailor-made characteristics of the food, and in particular for people dedicated to have a better lifestyle and who takes care of the wellness. And we would also like to deliver the product in a very fast way and convenient way. And this is our way to gain a premium price for this product. And this is also, since we really need to have an individualized product and process, this is the reason for which we cannot go for the cost advantage, because all these additional features will provide extra costs, and so this is not this cannot provide us with a cost advantage.
So we are here to have a look at why a proper IP strategy could protect the value added we have determined previously. And so the idea is to create around the customer benefit and our product a sphere of exclusivity, so that will prevent customers to find other equivalently attractive solutions from the competitors. And so the competitors can not take our place. The strategic prohibition and the presence of patents will help us to enforce it in case of infringement. And it gives us a protection over time during the lasting of the patents. And so here we have this exclusivity, and we drive the customer demand to our product.
My name is Teresa, and I'm going to explain about the IP generic strategies and the fortress monopoly. The reason why we are a fortress monopoly is because we have a large portfolios about related to patent rights. We also have because of the nature of our market, we have a market barriers, because our other competitors, it is not easy to enter to our market. And we have a consistent actions against some infringements. There are typical users of this kind of strategies, and there are typical sectors of our this kind of IP strategies. Of course, we explode the premium price, as my colleague explained before. Some problems could be the patent could expire in some point of the in the future could be, and other problems related to antitrust law. In general, the pros of our product is that you can our market is related to a specific kind of product. That could be customized depending on the consumer necessities. The points against the contrast are that the technology could be complex, and depending on that technology, it could be in a some point of the time it could be old, and well, the exclusivity can only be reached in part.
So hello, my name is Andreas. I like to present you the position of this new yogurt technology regarding the value-added monopoly. So first of all, to repeat or to introduce a value-added monopoly, what it's based on. It's based on product of user protection of user-relevant features, first of all. Secondly, strategic patents to obstruct competitors. And then first documentation and protection of the features. This strategy is basically used for the food industry as we are in. So for instance, for Beiersdorf and Nestle. And the typical sectors are consumer products, automotive, electrical engineering, and so on. And what is a key feature of this value-added monopoly? To exploit cost benefits and user benefits. So these are the main topics we are going on. And the problem, the inherent problem, is a time trap. So regarding our case, what are the pros for the value-added monopoly? First of all, innovation adds completely to the new customer benefits to an existing product. So for instance, we could protect the selling via the gym, the whole process of delivering, of transferring the information in order to produce this special product. And secondly, new features can be viewed separately from the other features, so from the already known prior art. How yogurt is used today. And thirdly, exclusivity can be gained around these features. So we have three pros for this value-added monopoly. And actually we found no contrapositions regarding this. So we would go for this value-added monopoly. Thank you very much.
So let's have a look at the role of IP for resource protection. We'll now take the resource perspective, where we consider that all companies have a similar market position to focus on what resources they have. First, we want to identify what are the elements of the value creation and the resources that are most valuable to deliver the customer benefit that we want to focus on. So what we want to do after we've identified them is make sure through the IP protection that these resources and these elements are not imitable or difficulty substitutable. We want to make them unique, make them rare, and we want to sustain that superiority through time. And beyond that, what we want is make sure that the company will be in a good position and will stay in a good position to appropriate the returns, the financial return from the exploitation of these resources and these value creation elements.